This stele is a monument of huge value since it's one of the oldest known historical documents. Hi everyone and welcome back to Exploring Art. This is Alessandro. Today we are going to discover one of the most important artifacts of the Sumerian art, the stele of the vultures. As you can see, we have just a few fragments. It's like a big puzzle. However, even these pieces can tell us a lot. First of all, when and where. This monument is dated around 2600-2350 BC, and it was made to celebrate the victory of the city-state of Lagash over its neighbor Umma, so we are in Mesopotamia. The fragments, in fact, were found at Tello in southern Iraq in the late 19th century. The bas-relief would have been 1.8 meters or 5 feet 11 inches high, that's why sometimes I call it monument, and it was made out of a single slab of limestone with carved reliefs on both sides. On one we can see a mythological scene and on the other the historical episode of the military campaign against Umma that we're going to read together. This side tells a story arranged on the stele in accordance with the traditional system of registers, these four sections. In the upper register, the king of Lagash, Inhatum, is marching at the head of his army. Just half of his head is visible, but we can identify him thanks to his helmet. He's wearing a woolen tunic over the left shoulder while the right one is uncovered. Behind him, the soldiers are marching in serried ranks, carrying long pikes and tall rectangular shields. And if we look carefully, we can see that the triumphant army is stepping over the enemy's bodies on which a host of vultures has already begun to feed. The stele takes its name from this scene. The inscription proclaims Inhatum struck at Umma. The bodies were soon 3600 in number. That was really kind and made the archaeologist's job easier for once, since we are sure about the event, and that's another reason why this monument is so important. The second register shows what seems to be a victory parade. The soldiers march in two columns, holding their spears raised behind their king, who is mounted on a chariot. The third register, much of it missing, shows the funeral ceremony. On the right, a small part of a possibly seated figure can be seen, while on the left, the scene is more complete and we can see the soldiers of Lagash climbing up a ladder with baskets of earth on their heads to bury the heaped bodies of their comrades. An important detail that shows how King Inhatum has been triumphant but respectful of the enemy, so a good advertising as well. In the fourth register, we can see just a hand holding a long spear that touches the head of an enemy. The scenes are very important, but probably the text written in Sumerian cuneiform script is even more. It's possible to read, in fact, that the stele was commissioned by Inhatum and a description of the events. That makes this monument really useful to understand this ancient population. For the moment, we stop here with the Sumerian series, but our journey continues with a new one in the next episodes. Subscribe to the channel so you can stay updated and check also my social medias and Patreon. Ciao!